Hello everyone, Harry Badger here. Welcome to my video on how to build an M56 Smartgun as used by the Colonial Marines in the amazing film Aliens. I want this Smartgun build to not only look cool and to be as close to the original ones in the film, but I also want it to shoot. Now I don't mean real bullets, as that's very illegal in the UK, but I am an airsofter and I would like this thing to sling out some BBs. In this video, I'm going to be introducing you to the build and running through some of the things that I've used for the project. First thing is the donor for this smart gun, which is an MG42 full metal World War II support machine gun. I'm using the airsoft version, which is made by AGM. Now you may need a UCAR or other valid defence to be able to purchase something like this in the UK, or if you're not from the UK, then you'll need some other kind of legal paperwork. And we'll also need a Steadicam vest to be able to support the smart gun, especially as the whole thing weighs over 15 kilos. Some of the M56 smart gun parts are just simply scrap metal motorcycle bits and pieces, along with some metal tubing, some bearings and nuts and bolts. The rest of the parts are 3D printed. If you search online for M56 smart gun STL or model, you may end up coming across this free 3D model on Thingiverse. It's full size and quite detailed compared to some of the other models I've seen, and all credit goes out to the original modeler. The only drawback of this model is it's totally solid. Now this would be fine if you wanted a full size, non-functioning prop for something like cosplay or to hang on your wall, and it would be a lot cheaper to make compared to this project. But for me, I'm going to modify this model so I can retrofit it onto the donor MG42. I'll put a link to this model and some of the other things that I've used in this project into the video description. So when I first looked at this build, I thought I would simply take an MG42 machine gun, then print out some M56 smart gun cosmetic parts and slap them on. However, it's not going to be as easy as that because there are some critical load-bearing parts of this build that need to be done right. If I don't get them right, then as soon as I pick this heavy beast up, it's likely to break. These load-bearing parts are where the smart gun is mounted to the Steadicam, the foregrip and the rear grip. I'm going to have to disassemble the MG42 first before I can start bolting stuff on. Okay, easiest thing to do is to remove the front bipod. This just unclips. Then off comes the drum mag. And the rear stock simply twists off. The trigger unit is held in place by a big pin and a C-clip. You remove this and the grip will pull down and then it will come out towards the rear. I can't completely remove it as it's blocked by the battery wire at the moment. So remove the two screws on either side and the small screw behind the hop, and the gearbox will pop out. And at this point I can remove the trigger unit as the wires are now free. The inner barrel can be slid out. Good lord, it's a long one. There are two screws holding the outer barrel, which is still on the inside. So I guess you would call this the inner outer barrel? I don't know. So after removing this bracket, the tapered barrel will slide out. And then finally the rear stock clamp is held in with two screws at the back. Oh, and I guess I had better remove the muzzle. That's all the disassembly I'm going to be doing on this. And I can take away the parts that I'm not going to be needing. That's the bipod, the stock, and the muzzle. Right, let me just move everything to make a bit of space, and I'll show you just a sneak of some of the bits that I'm going to be adding. A Kawasaki ZR7 motorcycle clutch lever. The movie version of the Smartgun used one from a Kawasaki AR125. Good luck finding one of those, and this is the closest match. Next up is a Kawasaki ER6 left side switch unit. The movie Smartgun version used one from a Kawasaki GPZ750 switch unit. Again, have fun trying to find one of those. And lastly, I've got some handlebar grips. The ones on the left are some foam grips, which are probably a closer version to the movie, but I do like the ones on the right hand, which are sturdier, rubberized grips. Not sure which ones I'm going to use yet. So that's about it for this video. That's all I need to cover this time round. I hope it gives you a little insight into the project. Next up, I'll be 3D printing some parts and starting to make the transformation from an MG42 into a cool-looking M56 Smartgun. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the other videos that are coming up for this Smartgun build series. So for now, this is Harry Badger, signing off.